I was driving down. There was this volcano that exploded three times. I was driving my motorcycle. I remember going over from Chile over the Andes Mountain, going down into Argentina.
I have a question about Chile, babe. What is Chile?
About what?
Chile, you said Chile?
Chile.
Yeah.
No, Chile.
What is that?
It's a Chilean country.
Country.
It's on South America. It's like long. It's about that long.
Does it have islands?
Huh?
It's
an island. There's a couple islands.
Oh, I'm going there.
Oh, you're going to like it?
Hey.
It's cheap. It's cheap. They got great food. They got great food. I'll tell you what. Anyway. Jeez, you made me lose my place. Where was I? Oh, the volcano. So I'm going down, you know, and it had already exploded once, and I thought I was safe, you know, and on the Chile side, the wind blows from east to west. So it was going from Chile over the mountains into Argentina. And all the ash went into Argentina. They were all mad at the Chileans. And I'm coming in, and up the mountain was beautiful. It was green, lush, it was gorgeous. Things I'd never seen before. Beautiful. And when I got to the top, it looked like the moon. It was ash everywhere. And as I went down, it was like more, it was like piled up like snow. And when I went in, the man from Customs and Immigration said, come on, we're about to close. I'm like, what are you talking about? This station's open for 24 hours. And he goes, no, look. And when I go to look, there's this big old cloud or something coming out of the mountain. I checked my stuff and I just started heading south as fast as I could. That was one of the challenges that I had. Another challenge that I had when I entered into from Costa Rica to Nicaragua, there was a car that was following me around. It was like a big compound. I had to go to different buildings to get my stamp. And I'm by myself. I wasn't Iron Man. I didn't have no security or cameraman following me around, no crew, no safety vehicle. I went by myself. That was the adventure. And when I'm going in, I had these three fools in the car and they're following me around. They're so obvious. I'm looking at them and I'm saying to myself, they're not invisible. You know, they don't have superpowers. You know? And I knew they were following me, and I had heard that there were kidnapping and robbery attempts, and so folks had died. And I saw this real black clouds coming in. So like in the summer when the storms come in, it rains for like 20 minutes and it's over. And it was real dark coming my way. So I got up, went to the gate, they checked my papers, and as soon as I took off, it just started raining. And I put it in second, third, fourth, and I'm doing like 60 miles an hour in a 30 mile zone. And they were keeping up to let me know that they wanted to do something. And the rain was coming down up the mountain and all the water was brown. And I'm riding through water and I don't know if it's this deep or this deep, but I said, hey, it's better that if I crash, something happens, better than them getting home because I don't know what they're gonna do. Eventually it got so bad that they pulled over because they couldn't see and I kept going. So that was that event. Going through Mexico, I broke down in the middle of Hurricane Carlos. And who comes to save me? Some guy that got deported in 1997. And he had this tire changing shop that was held up by about 10 tree limbs, or whatever, trucks. No wall, and that's where he lived. So I slept in a hammock for 10 days until I got my bike fixed. This is just some of the challenges that you get. Also mechanical failures. So I'm gonna play the next one for you.